Hello, we are discussing about GATE 2010 ECE paper, and this question is related to analog circuits. Assuming the op amp to be ideal, the voltage gain of the amplifier shown below is. Okay, there are four options are given. Out of that one, which is going to be the right answer, that we have to pick. So this is a given circuit. For this one, we are going to calculate voltage gain. Okay, and given that one op amp is ideal. Whenever op amp is ideal, the main important characteristic of op amp in ideal condition is AV is equal to infinite. Open loop gain of op amp is infinite. Open loop gain can be calculated as V naught divided by VID, that is input difference voltage. So from this one you can write it as V naught is VID is equal to V naught divided by AV, which implies nothing but V naught by infinite, that is nothing but 0. So VID is equal to 0. VID is nothing but difference in input terminals, that is non-inverting and inverting terminals. So that implies nothing but non-inverting terminal voltage and inverting terminal voltage is always same. This is going to be treated as virtual short. This concept is called as virtual short concept. So always for an ideal op amp, and if it is practical also, if AV is equal to infinite, for the op amp with open loop gain as infinite, always the voltage across inverting and non-inverting terminals will be same. So if you connect some voltage across non-inverting terminal at that time, the same voltage will result in the inverting terminal. Otherwise, if you connect some known voltage at the inverting terminal, the same voltage will be resulting in the non-inverting terminal because of virtual short, where that specifies that one voltage at both terminals has to be same because of infinite open loop gain. So this is non-inverting terminal is connected to ground, that implies nothing but 0 volts. So inverting terminal is must be at 0 volts. Okay, because of virtual short concept. From this one, this is what? This is, we can say it as V naught. V naught output voltage, the same V naught you can write over here. So apply KCL. Apply KCL. If you apply KCL across KCL at inverting terminal. KCL at inverting terminal is nothing but over here. Okay, so by that time 0 minus VI divided by R1 plus 0 minus V0 divided by R2 is equal to 0. Okay, these are the currents. Only two branches are connected, and there is no current flows into the input terminals. Current flowing through the internals of op amp, that is input terminals of op amp, is always 0, because ideal op amp is going to be having input impedance as infinite. Ri is infinite, is nothing but ii, input currents, current flowing into the terminals of the op amp is always 0. Okay, so that current flowing through inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal, they are always 0. So we are writing only two currents, that we are writing 0 minus vi by r1 plus 0 minus v0 by r2. So from this one you can write voltage gain. Voltage gain is nothing but v0 divided by vi. V naught divided by Vi is nothing but, you will can write it as minus R2 divided by R1. So this is what the expression, V naught is equal, V naught by Vi, voltage gain is nothing but minus R2 by R1. So the right option for this question is A. Okay, and the same thing can be specified in a different way. The same answer you can get in a different way. Okay, we can express. Circuit is going to be, redraw the circuit like this. This is nothing but, let us assume this is node 1 and it is node V naught. Okay, and if you are going to draw this one, this is what op amp with V naught, and it is negative terminal and it is positive terminal, that is inverting and non-inverting terminal. This is inverting terminal and it is non-inverting terminal. Okay, so look at this one. First we will consider the non-inverting terminal. Non-inverting terminal is directly connected to ground. Non-inverting terminal is directly connected to ground. So that we are writing like this. Next, inverting terminal. Inverting terminal is going to be connected with, this is what inverting terminal, it is connected with three things. One is with inverting terminal, the other is nothing but it is connected with VI. VI it is connected through R1. So through R1 it has to be connected. So this is VI, that is nothing but R1. And next, this is completed. Next, this is connected to V0. This is V0 node. So this inverting terminal, voltage at inverting terminal, this node, inverting terminal node, is connected to V0 through R2. So through R2 there is a resistor which is connecting towards V0, which is nothing but R2. And next, R3 is going to be a resistor which is connected from V0 to ground. So V0 to ground implies nothing but like this. This is R3. So this is what the effective circuit. The same circuit is nothing but it is looks like inverting op amp. It is inverting op amp with input as VI and feedback resistance as R2 and normal resistance is R1. The gain of inverting op amp is nothing but minus RF divided by R1, which is nothing but, in case of RF is nothing but R2 feedback resistance, divided by minus R2 by R1. The given circuit is nothing but simply inverting op amp, but the connections are looks like it's going to be a different circuit. If you read right, this is simple inverting op amp. The gain for that one is nothing but minus R2 by R1. So the right option for this question is A. Thank you.